yeah, yeah. In the Quran there is a verse, Surah 7:157, that it talks about Muhammad is prophesied in the Bible, in the Torah and in the Gospels. Can you tell me, where is it Muhammad prophesied in the Bible?
Fantastic. How much time I have?
Just a moment. Our cameraman, brother, are you recording? Are you keeping the time? He's not keeping... Brother, do you want to keep the time for us? Do you want to be the timekeeper? Okay. 2 minutes, 2 minutes, Yahya.
2 minutes, 2 minutes.
Okay. So, I repeat my question again. Where is it Muhammad? Where is it Muhammad in the Torah and in the Gospels?
The question was... Before I start anything, peace be upon everyone. Almighty God sent Jesus to the lost sheep of Israel, sent a lot of messengers to the lost sheep of Israel, and he sent Prophet Muhammad to the lost sheep of Israel and the lost sheep of Christianity as well. As in the Old Testament and the New Testament prophesies about Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, and I will give you now the reference. You can check over in your book, the scripture, Isaiah 42, verse 1:17.
Read it for me.
Deuteronomy. You don't need to check it now, because please don't interrupt. I will give you the reference, and you can take your time. Deuteronomy 18:18. You have John. Number 16, verse number 5 and 16. You have in Matthew, number 23:39. You have in Matthew again, 27:43. You have in Act, number 3, verse 22 and 26. We come back to Isaiah as well, 29. Verse number 12. And I have one more. And John, number 1, 19:21. Verse 19:21, when they ask John the Baptist, who are you? Are you Elijah? Are you the prophet? Or are you Messiah? And his answer, I am none of them. As well, I don't know if I mentioned this, Isaiah 28, verse number 10, 11, as well, number 42, verse number 4, and 11. And last in John, number 16, 5, 16, where Jesus, peace upon him, call him the Counselor or the Comforter. I'm finished or not? My time is done. Fantastic.
Let me ask you this. If God had gone through... So, Surah 7 verse 157, simply tells us, those who follow the messenger, the unlettered prophet, whom they find written in what they have of the Torah and the Gospel. If Muhammad is not in the Torah, and if Muhammad is not in the Gospel, that proves Quran is false book, Muhammad is false prophet, Islam is false religion. So, Yahya, you gave me lots of references. One of the references you gave me was Isaiah and also Book of Acts. Can you just clarify for me, where did you get the authority that Isaiah is the part of the Torah? Where did you get the authority and the information that Book of Acts is part of the Gospel? Give me the references. I love to hear, if Allah identified Isaiah as part of the Torah, if Allah identified Book of Acts as the part of the Gospel, give me your references. And please read from the chapters and then tell me how that those chapters tells us Muhammad's name is written there. All those verses, all proofs. Islam is false religion. Muhammad is false prophet. Quran is false book. Because all Bible does, as Bible talks about Muhammad, identifies Muhammad as the false prophet. So explain it to me. Where is the book of Isaiah identified as the part of the Torah, Yahya? And same thing for the book of Acts.
You're done?
Are you keeping the time? Okay. Do you want to be in charge of keeping the time?
Thank you for blowing away your Bible and denying all the reference from your own Bible, which you as well deny Deuteronomy 18:18, which you didn't include. You mentioned Isaiah, but you didn't mention John. You didn't mention you mentioned Acts, but you failed to mention Deuteronomy when God is speaking to Moses and tell him that I will raise among your brethren a prophet like you, and he will be a light for Gentiles, and you fail to mention any of that. I have confirmed that prophet is in your Bible, which you just said. You want even more proof, and you didn't even ask me about any verses or read any verses before you come back. I'm done.
So I think you had approximately a minute, Yahya. Yeah, just over a minute. I simply ask simple two questions. Where does it in the Quran Allah is identifying book of Isaiah as the Torah? Where does in the Quran Allah is identifying book of Acts as the gospel, Yahya? Anyone heard the answer? No, because you were shameful to tell us you were going against Allah while you were putting the book of Isaiah as the Torah, Yahya. I still want my answer. Where does Allah identify Isaiah and Acts, part of the Torah and part of the gospel? So now I'm gonna read the Deuteronomy chapter 18, and then you will all hear listen very carefully. You all hear Deuteronomy chapter 18 proves Allah is false God, Muhammad is false prophet, who should put to death. Let me read it for you. Yahya was shamed to read it, but I am gonna read it. I will raise up among them a prophet like you from among them, brethren. I will put my words on in his mouth, and I will tell them everything commanded him. If anyone does not listen to my words that the prophet speaks in my name, I myself will call him to account. But a prophet who proceeds to speak in my name anything I have not commanded him to say, or a prophet who speaks in the name of another God, must put to death. That's Deuteronomy chapter 18. Muhammad, according to Deuteronomy, according to the chapter you brought to us, Bible tells us Muhammad should put to death. And sadly, we couldn't do that. Jewish woman
time,
did that.
Time. I would like beg you to, when you speak, don't look at me and speak, because your voice is penetrating my ears and hurting me. Speak to the camera and don't look at me and speak to me, because you're hurting me. Really, you have
it hurts.
No, I need the protection for the ears. Not something sweet.
It
now.
Will help.
Thank you very much.
It is in your timing, by the way. This all.
Your time is gone.
Yeah, it's fine. It's fine for me. I need to protect myself. We have Song of Solomon, 5 number 15. Mouth is sweet. Mouth is sweet is talking about the Quran, because Quran is sweet actually. A radiant among 1,000. We all know that Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, entered Mecca with 1,000 victorious over his people. And Deuteronomy 18:18, when God speaking to Moses that I'm sending a prophet like you, and actually a man like you, that means he will marry, he will have children, he will have Sharia, like law of Moses. You can have Quran, Prophet Muhammad came with the Quran, and Quran have Sharia law. Jesus, peace upon him. The difference that Jesus, he can't come and comply by the law of Moses, and he didn't bring his own Sharia. Something else. When I say Isaiah 42, verse number 6 in Isaiah, a light for the Gentiles, a new song.
Gentiles.
No, the genitals.
No,
that's fine, guys.
Even verse number 10, a new song.
Time.
Have you heard the answer to my question?
No.
Simple answer. I am asking the third time to you, Yahya. Where is it Allah in the Quran identifying Book of Isaiah as part of the Torah? Simple question. Why are you playing like you play in the jungle like a shaklaban and not answering my question? Simple question. I will keep you accountable to that question, Yahya. That's my first question. First thing. Second thing is, I already made my point. Deuteronomy chapter 18 proves that Muhammad is false prophet who should put to death. Sadly, it was only Jew woman who put Muhammad to death. And what was the reason? If he was a true prophet, he would survive. And same Allah confirms, if Muhammad is not my prophet, I will cut his aorta, which Allah did. Deuteronomy chapter 18 proves Muhammad is false prophet who should put to death. For your information, for those of you who are watching, as it tells you, someone like Moses, it means Moses saw God face to face. All heaven came down for Moses. Moses did miracles. Muhammad cannot even be the nail of Moses, let alone like a Moses, Yahya. Can you please deal with the passage? Why, according to the passage, Muhammad, while he should put to death, yet he failed to put to death by Muslim community, Yahya? I will respond to the Songs of Solomon in next time.
As I said before, she is contradicting in the Bible, which tell us about the coming of Prophet Muhammad after Jesus, peace upon him. And as I mentioned, in Geometry 18:18, when God saying to Moses, I will put my word in his mouth and he will tell them everything I command him. Prophet Muhammad, he did just that because he stayed 40 years among his people and he didn't mention anything till the angel come and shook him and he started to tell him what to say. And he put his word in his mouth as the prophet, he speak what he hear from the angel. And the warning is for you, Christian and Jew, because God saying, if anyone does not listen to my words that the prophet speak in my name, I will myself call him to account. And this verse is enough warning from God against you. I'm finished.
You can't just say I finished, Yahya. And my questions are waiting answer. Where is it in your Quran? Here's the Quran. Where is it? Book of Isaiah is identified as the part of the Torah. Give me your answer. Soon after you, Allah identifies Book of Isaiah as the part of Torah, I am going to answer your question. Same question is the same with the Songs of Solomon. Where is it in the Quran? Songs of Solomon is identified as the Torah. It is not. Please bring those references for me, Yahya. Here's the Quran. It looks like Dawa Gangs comes to speakers gonna with our their Quran. I can lend you and then give me the references. in Sons of Solomon chapter 5 verse 16 is talking about Muhammad as a coming prophet, I am afraid to tell all Muslim world Muhammad is apparently homosexual, because Songs of Solomon chapter 5 is talking about someone who is writing poems towards their husband. Is Muhammad homosexual? I'll take that silent as yes. And we all know, according to Sharia law, what needs to be done to homosexual. If you put Muhammad in the Songs of Solomon chapter 5, I am afraid, according to Sharia, Muhammad should be killed. Let me remind you my questions. Where is it in the Quran? Book of Isaiah and Book of Acts and the Songs of Solomon is identified as the Torah. Simple question, give me your simple answer and then I will respond to that. Also, if Muhammad is like Moses and your criteria is Muhammad was married, Muhammad was this, can you tell me why Alexander the Great is not that person in Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 18? There is not much difference between him and Moses.
That time is finished, isn't it?
Yeah. First, I want you to answer my questions. If you are not going to answer my questions, I'm going to walk away, okay? Because this is the fourth time I ask you.
You claim...
He's Muslim, so he's fourth time.
You claim that the Prophet Muhammad is a homo. And I don't know why you claim that he's a homo, while we know that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, have 12 wives, and he have children, and he didn't have any kind of sexual or desire for men. All his companion have but respect and love and for him, and actually, what you're saying is very offending, and according to your Bible, homosexuality is condemned in your Bible, and you know it, that they are being asked to death. If a man comes with another man, they have to be put to death. And let me give you against the similarity between Moses and Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad and Moses both brought a new law. But Jesus did not come with a new law. Matthew 5, verse number 17, 18. Jesus come and comply by the law of Moses. He didn't come with a new law. He come to fulfill and to keep the law and not to destroy or abolish the law of Moses, which confirm, as you said, kill homo, kill sexual desire, kill the fornicator, kill the sinner, kill the people who don't believe in one God, kill other follower of God. Muhammad and Moses, both died
a
neutral death, while according to you Christianity, Jesus was killed on the cross. Muhammad and Moses both lie buried on earth, while Jesus, according to you, he was raised to heaven. He's not on earth.
Hello.
Okay. Jesus, Muhammad and Moses was spiritual and national leader, but Jesus was only spiritual leader, and he didn't go to war and he didn't fight. Prophet Moses, peace upon him, and Muhammad led war against non-believers. Jesus, he didn't lead any. Muhammad and Moses both was victorious morally and spiritually, while Jesus had only spiritual victory only. Finish. Okay.
So, anyone heard answer to my question? No. It was very simple question. What was the question? Where is in the word of Allah? Allah tells you Isaiah and Songs of Solomon is the part of the Torah. Simple question and still no answer. Are you you ashamed of the teachings of your God? I can say, yes, you are. When you force Muhammad, so-called fake prophet, in the Christian scripture, especially in the Songs of Solomon chapter 5, I've got no any other option to identify Muhammad as a homosexual beside anything else. If you force Muhammad that, in the context, that's what Muhammad needs to be. Be careful where you put your prophet. Be careful where you force your prophet. Those are simple mistakes you are making, and you are not even aware. You are telling people to kill your prophet, because according to the teachings of Islam, Muhammad should be killed because of his homosexual acts. Let me also remind my second question. I did ask you, if you compare Moses and Muhammad in the earthly categories, what is the reason that instead of Muhammad, that's not the Alexander the Great? Simple question, Yahya. Why are you playing shaklaban and running away my questions? Let me read something very unique, which you can only find in the teachings of Muhammad. This is narrated by Aisha. Remove the heart, the blood from him. I was repulsed by that. He started to suck the blood and removed it from his face. And he said, this is Muhammad speaking, if Usama is a man, if Usama was a girl, I would adorn him and dress him until I marry him off.
Time.
That's time. Very homosexual time. Thing to say.
Time.
Bye, George.
Time.
Are you going to answer my questions?
I answer your question and I'm going to answer it again. Do you not consider geometry part
Deuteronomy.
Of the Old Testament?
Deuteronomy.
Yeah.
That's not my question. My question is Isaiah.
Isaiah is not part of the Bible.
Is it part of the Torah? Is that that's my question?
Is Muhammad a puff? Yes or no?
Sorry, is Muhammad what?
Is Muhammad gay? Yes or no?
No, he's not a gay. And regarding,
are you sure?
Regarding the blood.
Are you sure?
Osama.
How did this agree?
But
he kissed the boys. We wouldn't kiss. The prophet said, I can't put my mercy in the hearts
my
of
time.
Allah.
It's my time.
Has taken away
it's
from
my
him.
Time. It's my time.
Just helping the gentleman out.
The
he doesn't
boys,
believe in God.
The boy she's talking about, they are the son of his daughter. And he kissed them. I have no problem with a prophet kissing his grandchildren and love them. Osama, he was his servant, and he was injured, and the Prophet Muhammad removed the blood of the child. It doesn't make him any blood sucker, while we know that
wasn't my question. My question was his feelings regarding this boy.
Let me now show you your Bible about the whole.
I
Leviticus.
Want you to answer my question. No, I want him
Leviticus.
To answer my question, Yahya. Why are you so afraid of answering my questions? Is that your afraid
you know,
face?
Like
is that your afraid face?
I beg her not to talk to me and look toward me because I have no more answer. I have no more answer. Anyway, my answer is your Bible actually confirm that killing homosexual witches, fortune teller, and follower of other religion, and I can give you the reference one by one. Leviticus 20, verse number 13, kill homosexual. Our Prophet, peace upon him, he wasn't homosexual. Kill fortune teller, Leviticus 20, 27. Kill death to follower of other religion. Exodus 22, verse number 19. Kill non-believer. 2 Chronicles 15, 12, 13. Even in geometry, kill the entire town if one person worship another god. Kill women who are not virgin on their wedding night Deuteronomy 22, 20, 21. Kill follower of other religion. Deuteronomy 13, number 7, verse 7 and 12. This is all your savage Bible talking about, and you're claiming against my prophet? I'm done.
Have you all noticed? Still no answer to basic question.
I'm going to drink.
Very simple question. Still no answer to the simple question. And now he's finding ways to run away. That says a lot about Islam.
I have nothing to say anymore.
Of course you have nothing to say anymore, because you just butchered Allah, you just butchered Quran, and you have no answer to my simple questions. Where is it in the Quran? Book of Isaiah is the part of the Torah. Where is it in the Gospel? Book of Acts is the part of the Gospels. I love to hear Allah to respond to that. And I told you why I called Muhammad. His intentions are not very nice when it comes to boys, because it is your prophet. When you put your prophet in the Songs of Solomon chapter 5, there is no any other option for any human beings to come to the conclusion as Muhammad is normal human being. That's not an option. Muhammad is the one who puts his tongue on the mouths of boys. Muhammad is the one who wants to marry them off with dressing them up. That says a lot about his sexual lifestyle. But that's not my question. For you to bring up all those verses, all proofs, Islam is false religion. Why is that? Because those very verses tells you, points you to Messiah who died on the cross for your sins, which you deny. Let me ask my questions again to you. If Muhammad is like the Moses, who did miracles, for whom all the heaven come down, can you simply tell me, when you put Muhammad with Moses in the earthly criteria, as he married, as he had kids, as he brought new law, why that cannot be the Alexander the Great? Simple questions. Just answer my simple questions. Can you please tell me why still you follow a man who clearly heard from the Satan, even according to Deuteronomy? Even if I go with your approach, still Muhammad received the verses from the Satan, according to your own verses.
Time.
If you are not going to answer my questions, I'm going to walk away, Yahya.
Please, look there when you talk to me.
Yahya, don't play that child
please,
game
I'm
with me.
You.
Don't play that child game with me. Remember my question, answer them. Sir, do you want answer to the question?
Yes, what she's claiming.
Do you want answer?
I want a question.
So he wants answer to the questions. I want answer to the questions.
Can you just be quiet? Just let me talk. You have your talk. It's shameful that you're saying that Prophet Muhammad, he sucked on the tongue of his grandchildren as he kissed them, because he, even if he kissed his grandchildren, if he kissed his grandchildren,
not kiss, put his tongue there. No, he's just like misrepresenting his religion.
Can you just have some self-respect? I have a child, he's 6 years old, and I'm not ashamed even to kiss his tongue or to kiss his little. This is my child, and I'm proud of my child. This is, we know that our children, they are like our heart. We love them so much, even they are dearer to us more than ourselves. What did Prophet Muhammad bring? Bring equality, bring unity, bring purity, bring sincerity, charity, bring humbleness, bring modesty, bring forgiveness, bring courage, bring trust, bring love and kindness and mercy and compassion, love. And he's not interested in forgiveness, because forgiveness, it should be free. But your God wants a price tag to forgive the sinner. Your God is the biggest sinner as he incarnate and become two God instead of one God. We have two God, one in heaven, one on earth. And the one on earth come instead of glorified by the Father, he was humiliated and led by the Father to die on the cross, a brutal death. And this is what your God is. You're talking about my prophet. Why you forget your God is angels God, unforgiving God, killer God, criminal God, who sent his innocent son to die for the sinner.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. And you,
Christian. Your time is up now.
Yeah,
this
exactly.
I'm done with you, Yahya.
This is not the real
so,
Christianity.
One of the things you would expect for those Dawa gangs who come to speakers gonna week after week to improve their debate skills. That's something you would expect. My question was to you, it was a very simple question. Surah 7, verse 157. Muhammad should be in the Torah and in the Gospel. If Muhammad is not there, your Quran is a false book, your prophet is false prophet, and your ideology is false ideology. And what we saw here, you just proved it to us. Yes, Islam is false religion. Muhammad is false prophet. Quran is false book. Because Muhammad is not mentioned in the Bible as a coming prophet, yet prophet who should put to death according to teachings of the Moses, according to teachings of Jesus. Here's something I am very proud of. Next week, we are going to celebrate the Resurrection Day. It is the Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal Word of God, who did not step back when he saw his people were in the sin. Who did not watch and then just said, oh, well done, I will destroy them if they do not commit any sin. But he concerned for the sin of mankind. He concerned for your sin. He concerned for my sin. And he concerned for us all. What he did for that, he came down. He took up human nature. While he was King of Kings, he became a servant. He wasn't flying around with the jets. He wasn't walking around as the kings, but he took up the servant form. He lived as a servant.
Time.
I finished with you, Yahya.
He lived as a servant and died
on the cross.
Hello.
For the sin of mankind.
Hello.
He did not stay dead. On the third day, he rise again. Today, I am forgiven once for all. My heart is washed, my brain is washed, all of me is washed because the blood and grace of Lord Jesus Christ. It was your opportunity, since I proved you your book is false, your prophet is false, to repent. But all you do is playing the Shaklaban game and forgetting what Lord Jesus Christ
time.
Did for you.
It's my time.
Yeah, I am done with you. I gave you a chance to answer my questions.
I will answer
you
now.
You did not answer my questions. I am not here to spend all my time for one question for five times. No, you had your chance. You ignored my questions. All you did was to prove those people Islam is a false religion. Muhammad is a false prophet. And Muhammad is the broken bridge. He's going to take you to paradise. Going to give you virgins. But you know what? You are not going to satisfy those virgins. Because you are desired for something else. You are desired to meet up with your Maker, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, Lord Jesus Christ. All Muhammad does is put the strong bridges to take you to hell.
If your Bible doesn't mention Prophet Muhammad,
it was your chance.
If your Bible doesn't mention Prophet Muhammad,
Jesus Christ,
that means your Bible,
that means
your Bible is false as well.
You heard the
because
truth.
A person,
and you are
a person,
repent,
a person
Yahya,
who being false.